Last week, the Intercontinental GT DLC for Assetto Corsa Competizione got released. Introduced were four new tracks, where especially one of those tracks really wasn't widely featured before in any other sim. While Suzuka, Bathurst and also Laguna Seca should be rather familiar with most of you guys, the Kyalami circuit in South Africa is widely unknown so far. So, to get the most out of the DLC, one should be able to maneuver around the circuit without crashing, right? This more or less means learning every track by heart, which is especially difficult if you're unfamiliar with a circuit and have never seen it anywhere before. So, how does one best approach this problem? Well, this is the main topic of this video, where I'm going to explain how I personally go through this process as efficiently as possible. So, here we are now in ACC at the Kyalami circuit in South Africa, and as you can see in the top right corner, I've never ever driven even a single lap around this track. So, the very first thing I want to do here is to drive like 2, 3, 4 really slow laps around the circuit, just so that I can get used to the layout of the track. At this point in time, you're really not focusing on pace. Your main concern should be that you can safely and consistently lap the circuit. Now, if you are a beginner or just starting out with sim racing, this process naturally will take you longer than someone who, let's just say, is sim racing for 2 years already, because he already has a bit of a feeling for the game as a whole. A small tip that I can give you though is to connect track characteristics with each other. Like, for example, if we fast forward a bit, we have this long, flowing right-hander. Now, this part of the track stands out a little bit because it is a right-hander where the track also goes a bit downhill. So, what I did is to make a connection between this corner and the next. So, I have this long flowing right-hander and immediately after I am at the corner exit, I know that I have to brake at the 50 meters sign and also that the next corner is a 90 degree left turn. Now, while I am entering this corner, I have this very steep curb on the left side, which tells me where I'm currently at the track, and that after this corner comes a little straight into another downhill left turn. If you now consistently make connectors like this, it will significantly speed up the learning process of a new track. Anyways, after you're somewhat comfortable with the track layout, it is now time to tackle the racing line. For this, you want to drive around the track still slowly, but additionally to just learning the track, you are now looking left and right to the track and try to spot some braking points that you can use later and that are standing out of the scenery in the background. Now, two quick examples that I can give you here are firstly this post on the left side as I'm approaching this corner, and another reference would be this like bluish, I don't know what it is, bluish poster on the left side as I'm approaching the penultimate corner. Now, if you think that you know how the racing line should look like and how you should approach each corner, you can up your speed now a bit and also adjust your braking points accordingly. At this point, you should know the track's layout and your racing line by heart and can therefore start hot lapping. This means it is time to get serious. Go out there and hot lap as much as you can until you feel that you got a lap without any major mistakes. If you have achieved this, then first of all, good freaking job, because you are now able to lap at a circuit that a few minutes ago was completely new to you. But secondly, and also more importantly, do not leave me hanging just here. Stay with me. The next step you should take is to save your replay and analyze your hot lap. For this, you should preferably choose a third-person camera which is located behind your car and analyze how you approach different corners, and also keep an eye on your car's behavior as a reaction to your inputs. This should fix common problems like overdriving or underdriving, where you are, for example, sliding into a corner because you approach it too fast and are not braking early enough, or the other way around, you're entering a corner too slow, or rather exiting into slow and are not using the full track. Now, the last step that isn't really a necessity but I would still recommend is, after you have successfully learned this track and are able to do consistent hot laps around it, just take a break from the game as a whole for about 10 to 15 minutes, where you are doing something completely else, like, I don't know, make yourself something to eat, or stay hydrated, or exercise, or I don't know, something else that has nothing to do with the game that you are playing. Now, after this break, go back into the game and try to do some hot laps. What should happen now, or what you should notice now, is that you are starting to make minor mistakes that you didn't make before. After a few laps, you should feel a groove again and be hot lapping like your old self. What this does now is to help you build muscle memory and therefore also improve your consistency around the newly learned track. Now, let's move on to the final conclusion. If you want to learn a new track, you should first of all make a few slow laps around the track itself so that you can get used to its layout. Don't forget to connect track characteristics that stand out to more easily remember the track itself. After you are somewhat comfortable with the track's layout, you should now try to spot some braking points and think about the racing line you should take for each and every corner. After you've got some braking references, you can up your pace and adjust them accordingly. Keep hot lapping until you did one lap where it didn't make any major mistakes. Now go and analyze this replay and start hot lapping again with your fixed mistakes. To further improve your consistency, take a short break from the game for about 10 to 15 minutes and come back and start the hot lap afterwards. So yeah, this is basically it for this video. I hope you learned something new, and if you happen to enjoy this video, you could consider subscribing to this channel for more sim racing content. And with that said, I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers!